Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I've got a lot more light coming into this room now. I finally got rid of this tree. There was this gnarly, awful tree in the neighbor's yard, the dentist's yard. I've got a dentist next door. And I said to the guy, come on, it's hanging over the house. It's getting a bit damp. And so if you hear a guy outside with a bar or an axe or a chainsaw or something, that's probably the guy's working on the fence at the moment. So my apologies. Now, but the light's going to be good for the jungle in the back here. We're going to talk about polyphenols today. So what the heck are polyphenols? It sounds like a weird kind of a name or some sort of creature or something. In fact, these are compounds found in a variety of natural, you know, natural things, plants and seeds and nuts. And we're going to talk a bit about that today. I'm going to make a few videos about polyphenols to explain a bit about this. So polyphenol is a very powerful compound found in a plant. There's four or five different types of polyphenols. There are phenolic compounds and, you know, many different types. Flavonoids, for example, belong, and lignans, and you might have heard these names. They fall under the flavor, under the polyphenol category. So these are the things that make plants brightly colored. So when you look at bright red or bright purple, or, you know, like a black color, like a really dark color, it's usually the polyphenol content that's responsible for, you know, the coloration of that food. Now, polyphenols are very, very healthy for you. They're found in various foods. Onions, for example, contain different flavonoids like hesperidin and rutin, which are polyphenols. I eat onions and garlic every day. I think they're a fantastic food to eat. But tea, green tea, you probably know about green tea, you know, with the polyphenol content. Epicatechocollagenin or some flippant thing, ECCG or something. It's a long name, but that's also a flavonoid found in green tea. Then, of course, we've got red grapes, red wine, we've got dark chocolate, we've got all the berries, you know, the beautiful purple berries. I mean, these are fantastic things to eat. Now, antioxidant property is quite high with the polyphenols, but so is the anti-inflammatory component, you know, with some of these. So it's really worth looking at polyphenols as part of your diet, or include foods that have a good polyphenol content, particularly because of their effect on so many areas of the body, like the blood vessels. Okay, they also reduce free radical damage, so they absorb oxygen. They suck oxygen up, basically. So they stop a lot of damage, DNA damage done to cells. And there are many, many studies now that show that people with a high polyphenol content have a big ability to reduce the risk of developing heart disease and diabetes in particular. So you really want to include these things into your diet on a regular basis, the polyphenols. Fantastic to eat. So maybe you're drinking tea every day now, or maybe like me, you like berries. I mean, we've got over 30 blueberry bushes in the yard. We grow lots of blueberries for this reason, because they're so good for the eyes and the brain and, you know, the small blood vessels. So the value, the ORAC value, the oxygen reducing absorption capacity value, the ORAC value, O-R-A-C, is what we define the level, you know, how important the ORAC value, how high the ability to absorb oxygen will give you an understanding on how powerful the polyphenols are. If we look at, for example, a red delicious apple, we'll have an ORAC value of over 5,000, whereas a green apple will sit well below it. Now, why? Well, that's because the red apple is red. It's got that red coloring. Okay, blueberries have got an ORAC value of over 6,000. This is per 100 grams. So 100 grams of blueberry is 6,000, so that's quite high. But when we get up to the dark chocolate, we're getting up into the tens of thousands with the dark chocolate. Baking chocolate, that awful, bitter, bland sort of dark baking chocolate, is sky high in antioxidants. Okay, so, you know, it just goes to show, and you can get baking chocolate quite cheap. They did a study several years ago where they were giving people one bar of chocolate a day, and they found that it reduced their blood pressure because of the dark chocolate. Isn't it incredible? So that's a bit about polyphenols, okay, and the foods you find them in, and the fact that they are antioxidant primarily, but also many are anti-inflammatory. So you really want to be looking at a diet that contains plenty of, you know, foods containing polyphenols in them. This is the reason why your grandma always said to you, don't leave the table until you've finished your vegetables, okay? So some, you know, foods contain more carbohydrates than polyphenols. If you look at brown rice, that's got a polyphenol content to it. I mean, that gives the rice the brown colouring, but the carb content's quite high on it. Whereas vegetables, they've got a much lower carb content and a much higher nutrient content. Plenty of water, plenty of nutrients in them, and a lot of vitamins in them. And that's why vegetables and fruits are so good to eat, to include in your diet, if you want to live a bit longer than you are now, I would say. Anyway, that's all about polyphenols, and we'll catch up with you in the next video. Thanks for tuning in.